Hello, welcome to Cursed Brains. In this video, I will be showing how to download and set up Phoenix OS as a dual boot. Visit the following Phoenix OS official website link to download OS without any viruses or malware, link in the description included. You will be able to see multiple download options. Let me clarify each one of them for you. There are two different versions of Phoenix OS. One is the latest version based on Android 7.1 with two installation options that are EXE installer and ISO image. The other version of Phoenix OS is based on Android 5.1. There is one more way to download Phoenix OS, which automatically detects your device suits 32-bit or 64-bit. We have two download options. I will be downloading through Mega. As you can see, the OS has been downloaded successfully. Now we will create a new drive to install Phoenix OS. Get into disk management through right click on the start menu. As you can see, we have multiple drives. From one of these drives which have extra empty space, we will shrink and create a new drive for Phoenix OS from that drive. You need to allocate the amount of space you want to give for Phoenix OS. The more space you will give, the better it will be. You should allocate space between 4 GB to 32 GB. We have successfully created a new drive to install Phoenix OS. Now let's install it on the drive. Here's our downloaded Phoenix OS file. Double-click it for the installation process. Click on Install and select the drive letter, which was named for the new drive created for Phoenix OS installation. Select the amount of space you want to give for Phoenix OS installation, as per the amount of space of the drive you have created for Phoenix OS. Click on Install and wait for installation completion. The wait time depends on how much space you have allocated. Once the installation completes, there will be three options: Restart Now, Remind Later, or Just OK to Ignore. Let's restart the system. After restarting the system, you will be directed into Phoenix OS. Wait until you see any setup screen. So here's we are on the Phoenix OS setup screen, change the OS language to English. Accept the user license agreement. And then skip all the further steps, as the default keyboard of OS will be of Baidu, which will make us difficult to type anything. And now we are on the desktop screen of Phoenix OS, let's change the default keyboard to Android keyboard. As we have changed the default keyboard, now we can type anything without any difficulty, let's try to connect to local Wi-Fi. And we have successfully connected to the local Wi-Fi. Let's sign into Google account and try to use Play Store to download an app. And we have successfully installed Chrome, let's check out. As you can see, Google Chrome is working great, so do the Phoenix OS is also running flawlessly. Hope I have explained each and everything clearly. Leave your comments and doubts in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe for much more videos. Thank you for watching this video.